I have to sample that merchandise later on. Now, we are keeping an eye peeled on Oliver Reed in his dressing room via the Ollie Cam system. It's just recently been copyrighted. Now, face it, the guy is Flip City. But is he going to be too dangerous for the Word studio audience? Well, we're going to have one more test. We're going to find out with the help of this pretend producer and his bite-sized companion.
The delay is inexcusable, but...
Really, really sorry.
That's the way it goes.
But let's just slip it in.
This is like, this is your life.
So you can see exactly what's going on. What is going on? Jesus Christ. That looks like, you and me. That means I ought to get out fast. So someone will be in for you imminently, and I hope you have a good one. Bye.
Bye.
It's on.
This is astounding. The penny has not dropped. Well, I'm going to have to gently clue him in person. He obviously thinks that he's on all the channels all the time. Well, anyway, Terry, we'll meet you on the sofa later.
Also in the same old repeat, Ashley is a man. One of Britain's greatest living character actors, Mr. Oliver Reed. Welcome to the show. Or I should say Ollie, really, shouldn't I? No, that's nice.
No, when I was in the army, my name was Corporal Reed 2332-4533.
What's that?
Bird shit.
Also, you still got the old tattoo from your national service days.
Most things I have in my life, including the assuasions.
Mm. I think I'm still wearing your demob suit here.
Yes,
as well.
We're going to be. Well, that's apparent.
Now, throughout your life, you've had a reputation, you know, in like films as being a bit of a rebel and a bit of a brawler and everything. When did you first get that reputation?
I suppose I grabbed that when I was learning. when I was learning Amo, Amas, Amat, Tamamas, Amatis, Amant. I love, they love, Pugilo, a lot of the things that happened in a very private school that I lived in. I went to a school that was full of dunces, and they suddenly started to.
I don't know. I mean, the thing is,
Haven't you funny?
Katie.
Let me tell you something. When you went to a private school during the war, it was a school whose father was not dead, or he was full of counsel.
Hmm. So it's tough times. Listen, we did something, because we wanted to see you.
No, I'm not talking about your football score. I'm talking about the war.
Mm-hmm. We actually wanted to show you this, right? This was your manager's idea, I ought to add.
Now, gosh, that was a surprise.
Why?
I'll tell you what, sunshine. There was not too much surprise when I was in there in the 50s. When I was in the cake, and there are a lot of people out there that would like to sing rock and roll. Because I'm a rock and roll singer, you know.
Oliver, did you know that we were spying on you?
Would I know anything, madam?
We thought that you were just being a gentleman. We just had to keep tabs on you in case that you were going to be too crazy for the show. But you're not. Are you?
Strangely enough, there is always a little bit of madam. Keep your eyes to the wall, my darling, while the gentlemen ride by. Uh-huh. And there's the great mystery in life. Nobody's really supposed to know, especially on the word. Keep your eyes to the wall. And so youth has an amazing thing. Doesn't matter whether the bucks or the girls down here, keep the horses to the wall.
I mean, Oliver,
we're going to give you your moment in a minute. I hear you're a heterosexual.
I'm very glad you know this. Now, I must have had, in like those sort of rare moments of sobriety and everything, I mean, on After Dark, when you walked into the dressing room looking for the feminist writer Kate Miller and said, where's the bull dyke? Do you kind of have feelings of regret about saying things like that later
no,
on?
No, a lot of them supported me in the Navy. You know about the Wrens.
Oliver, you said that you're a rock and roll star, and I want to hear a burst of Wild Thing. The only way that you can do it.
No, well, strangely enough, the funny thing about this record was that it started a long time ago with Higgins and I made a film in my head, made a thing called Wild Thing. But
well,
strange enough, it was made by Pye, with Ray Horrocks, was the producer, long time ago, before you were all born. And that's nothing wrong with that, because I think there's a lot of enthusiasm. Shut up, I haven't finished yet.
Oh, no.
I know you've got pretty locks, my
girl. I just want you to sing for us, is all.
Wild Thing. Listen, yeah. Wild Thing.
We've not got Reg Presley in the Trogs for you, but we've got some great lads from the...
What did you say?
We haven't got Reg Presley in the Trogs for you, but we've got Ned's Atomic Dustbin out there who want to accompany you on Wild Thing.
And they'd love
you to go. And you've got your jacket left from the Leather Boys. Thanks for coming on. I hope you're going to finish on a song. That's what they always say, don't they?
Put your hand at me, boy.
Grab Cheers. That microphone and sing that
Brilliant.
Song.
Get your microphone and let's
roll.
Players out.
No!
You're rock and roll. Come on. Get in there, kid. Come on.
Out next Saturday at the later time of 1:45.
Love you, Walt. Thanks, chicken. Got everything. Got everything for me, Walt. Gonna shoot everything, Walt.
What's doing there? Oh, God. Cramp.
What happened?
Giving me cramp. Oliver, are you feeling all right now, mate? Yes, he's been in a bad way, hasn't he?
Just had a Huey. But then I'm not pregnant.
No.
You've done the test, have you? Yes. Well, it has to be first thing in the morning, I think. Listen, we'll try. We'll try this, and if it doesn't work, we'll have a commercial break. Did it brass you off that, because you're a very good actor, that people think of you in terms of the pub as opposed to the film? Yes, well.
Yes, well.
I can sit here just as long as you can, Oliver. We can wait all morning. No, we can't.
No, let's not make this into a competition, please. Because I know who will win.
Promise, come on.
Who'll blink first?
Come on.
Oh, not one of them.
Arm wrestling and women in love.
Come on, get that side.
All right, sorry about this, love.
Come on, then. All right, I'll just sit here and enjoy
myself. You ask the questions.
I could do with a rest.
You know, it's usually boiled eggs for breakfast, isn't it?
I have a feeling, Oliver, that you're going to win this. But then my dad said never to be defeated.
Don't you think, Richard, that
yes.
This might not be very well advised?
Well, I don't think I've got much
I'll
choice,
move
actually,
the coffee
love.
Cup.
Yeah, just move that out of the way. Now, you realise you're going to be humiliated here, don't you, Oliver? You say go, Judy.
Right, go.
I knew I had it in me.
You're a kind man.
I knew
man,
I had
Oliver.
It in me.
You're a kind
yes, you're
man.
Kind man. Thank you for
you
that.
You really are.
Right.
Listen, we were chatting earlier. You were saying that you really were slung out of 12 boarding schools.
Hmm.
Why?
Because I couldn't spell.
Oh, come on.
No, that's true. And, you know, tutors at that time, or masters, as you probably know them in your inferior school.
You went to Manchester High.
Went to Manchester High School for girls.
Well, I wasn't trying to sing its halloo its praise to the reverberate trees and make the babbling gossip of the air cry out, Manchester High.
Manchester High is very cross at the moment because they're suing the government for publishing some very sort of
statistics.
Wrong statistics.
Why,
about
they changed the colour of the knickers.
No, I think they're still navy blue.
Only by the week.
As far as I remember. Go on, tell me about, no, seriously, why were you chucked out of boarding school?
Because I couldn't spell or add up and I was dyslexic. And so they thought that I was just thick and trying to do a runner.
Mm.
Have it on my toes. Mm. And it was a fairly serious thing for me. So I became very privileged on the athletic field.
Yeah.
So I used to run faster than most people. My father used to say to me, if you want to emulate an ape, then grow 8 times as much hair on your body than you've got and run 12 times as fast. And get all those silly little tin cups and put them on your granny's table and come back and think that you're wonderful. So I did.
In fact, didn't he tell you not to win more than 4? Because any more than that was
gluttony. But he thought I was going to kill myself.
Mm.
But then if you're going to be privileged enough to behave like a gorilla or a monkey or...
Sorry, Oliver. I didn't mean to interrupt your flow.
Stop tittering, girl.
Bangy, bang, 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 bang.
Go on.
I pulled your missus.
Why, because I'm laughing at you.
Has he?
Just because I laugh at you doesn't mean I fancy
you. Are you smitten
you.
My own heart's desire?
I adore him. I absolutely adore him.
Pulled your missus. Cracker.
Yeah. Go on, tell us about your relationship with your father.
He doesn't appreciate me, because he thinks that I'm a monkey.
Is he still alive, your old man?
Just. Yeah. Brain dead.
Yeah. Even though you say it yourself.
Well, he was a racing journalist. You've got to be brain dead if you're a racing journalist, because you're never on the once-er, are you?
Yes.
You're always on the also-ran.
Yes, look at John McCrurick.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you going to ask your first question again?
No, I think it's interesting what you're saying about boarding schools and stuff. Were you happy there? Or did it make you miserable?
No, but I was captain of athletics, so of course I was, because I was a sort of hero figure.
Mm.
And when Douglas Manderson, who was the bully of the school, left school, I knew that I could go round the quad to the tuck shop, and if I bumped into anybody, they were going to say sorry.
This guy, this bully, did he bully you?
Mm-mm.
I can't imagine you being bullied. I can't imagine you
Well,
being...
I was, but I gave him a mouse under his eye. And I got my first scar ever on my forehead.
Hmm.
But then, you know, people have been dukely crowned.
What was his name again? I hate school bullies.
Douglas Manderson.
He's still alive, do you think?
He's very bald, if that's alive. But then you're brain dead.
Thank you. We're waiting for the insults to flow this way.
Yes.
Go on.
Well, it's probably... No, I'll ask the first question you asked them before.
Hmm.
Does it annoy you that... I mean, do you play up to this image of being a hellraiser? Or does it get on your nerves?
No, I belong to my people. I belong to the acting profession.
Mm.
I can't be terribly serious about that observation. I can only be just about it.
Mm.
And it's rather like going to church. Some people believe in God.
Mm.
A lot of people believe in rock and rollers.
Yes, I think that was an answer.
No, it is, no. I know what he's saying, I think.
No. But, I mean, if you are.
This was known, that was what was known as the suicide pass.
That's him not picking it up.
Do you rehearse that in the morning?
No.
No rehearsals necessary.
If you, I mean, if you do go out drinking, do you tend, when you do go out drinking, I mean, you're obviously perfectly sort of sober in here and everything, do you know that you're going to have a huge binge? Or do you think you only drink as much as ordinary people, other people, or what?
No, I pretend to.
You pretend? To drink what? To drink more than you do?
No, to be like other people.
I've seen you on a, I can't remember which chat show it was about 10 years ago, and you looked completely stoicus when you came on. And you kept it up for about 10 minutes, and you were as sober as a judge, and you suddenly clicked it on. And you completely, I mean, I can't remember who the poor host was. But you really, you like throwing people, don't you? You really like sort of throwing a spoke in the wheel.
That's why I used to play villains. I'd much rather play the clown.
Yeah.
Because, and there was that fat Australian journalist. James, was it his name? Anyways, he's from, where were
you? Oh, you mean James Thingley, BBC Two.
Yeah. The one with no hair.
And he said to me...
Hi, James.
Yes,
Hi, James.
And he leant across over his derby and said to me, Oliver, why do you drink? And what a ridiculous question to ask anybody in any country, in any world, why they go into a bar. They go in there to socialise, to pull a bird or to bullshit. And you're not quite sure what I'm doing yet.
Mm. Absolutely right. Absolutely right.
Bothers me really.
No, it doesn't actually. We've seen it all.
It's an interesting performance.
We had that Jeffrey Bernard here last week, you know. Very nice man. And he's about 60, so he's a bit older than you. But the ravages of drink. Did you smoke? Still, no. But the ravages of drink on
what
him
mean,
were painful.
Ask me a question, don't give me the answer at the same time.
No, thank you.
Just as you paint your face orange.
He's been saying that all morning.
It's a tan, and it's fading fast.
And he drinks at the Coach and Horses.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. In Soho. But the can say was, there were pictures of him in his biography, which showed him only 10 years ago looking good. I mean, handsome and all the rest of it. But the ravages of drink have written all over him. With you, really, I mean, you're getting a bit older, as are we all, but you don't look... You don't look ravaged.
You should try being on top.
What? Stop cutting to these close-ups, Wendy.
You mean a different sort of... In different angles and different lights, you look different.
What's this?
Oh, this is pointless. Yes.
No, it's not. What's this little, can we have a close-up of Oliver's right cheek? Talking of mice under eyes, what's this little heart?
Better than tears of wisdom.
Yes, well, indeed it would be, I suppose.
It's like Trivial Pursuit, this, isn't it?
No,
except the questions are in the wrong
place. Not quite, girl.
Well, I think we'll end it there.
Is that it? Are we out of time?
Thank God for that. Oliver, it was lovely to meet you. We'll be hearing a little more of your wonderful record at the end of the show.
Wild Thing.
OK.
See, we still give you a plug.
Can we say goodbye now? Susan Brooks next. See you in a minute.
Wild Thing, I think I love. But I want to know for sure. So come on and hold me tight.
I love you.
Wild thing, you make my heart sing.
Gonna make you sing. Wild thing,
you make everything.
Come here, wild thing.
Wild thing.
Love you, wild thing.